We're testing for tilapia, right? And you should have this about the same volume and everything, right?
I think the impact of having my students do citizen science and investigations that are connected to the real world, the knowledge sticks. There's something that relates to them. They learn that knowledge is bigger than just academic classes.
So just click run test now?
Yep, and now just leave it.
So the string theory model of education is a discovery process for kids to be exposed to both the arts and the sciences. Students interact with artists in residence, scientists in residence, and entrepreneurs in residence to give them real-world experiences they wouldn't receive elsewhere.
In STEM, we do a lot of things that connect with the real world. This year, we started to do DNA and PCR, which is polymerase chain reaction. We bought fish from local restaurants.
And we're just testing whether or not the restaurants are actually serving us what they are saying they're serving us.
Last week, we picked 8 different restaurants that you guys go to. Many of them are in South Philadelphia. And over the weekend, we picked up samples of white tuna and red snapper.
So this is a unit about our food and what might be in our food or how our food is produced. Overfishing and replacement of different types of fish and seafood is becoming a very big problem.
Tuna is commonly replaced with escalar. Red snapper is commonly replaced with tilapia, and people don't know about that.
Some people can have a very adverse reaction to escalar, so that's why it's a little bit problematic.
The idea is to apply a lot of the molecular biology techniques that we learned to their own environment.
We're going to use the BioMeme devices.
We have a partnership with a startup technology company called BioMeme. They have a very mobile device that they use for a lot of field work and citizen science.
It's a portable thermal cycler that allows you to test DNA wherever you are. So you don't have to be a scientist to test the environment.
The person with the swab is going to gently touch the clean cut surface of the fish. You're going to stick it into the tube and you're going to twirl it around a bunch. This is the most crucial part to make sure that you get enough DNA.
Hold up your strip of tubes. You're going to take 10 microliters of the DNA you just extracted and put it in the middle well.
We want to make sure that students understand that you need to control your experiments. So if they have a positive control, we have escalar DNA that they put in there. Their middle one is their sample, and then the one on the right is water.
Once you've pipetted into that last well, our samples are going to sit in here.
A BioMeme device pulls the DNA from each sample. You can hook up your phone to it, and there's an app where you can run it in a half an hour for the test results to come back.
DNA is double-stranded. Through the process, we heat it up, and it splits apart into 2 even strands. So we have the base pairs of 1 strand, and then we test it with 1 strand of the escalar DNA, and if it matches together to make 2 whole strands, it's positive for escalar.
We have 3.
So our positive control is positive, which is good.
So now here's our test. What do you think?
You tested positive for what?
Escalar.
Escalar. Yeah. Okay.
So overall, over 50% of our test came back positive for mislabeling. That corresponds with a bunch of articles that we've been reading up on. Other people have been doing the same experiment and they're getting the same results.
So is that what you guys expected?
No. I thought they just wouldn't switch that much.
It's a pretty big number, right?
Say I was allergic to tilapia and then they replaced it and I thought I was buying red snapper. Can I sue them for that?
They might not know and they're
maybe they're getting fooled.
Yeah, they're getting fooled
by the people who are giving them the fish.
Because these were restaurants that they go to or they have some sort of personal connection to the people that work there, I think that brings this extra piece into figuring out what to do with data to be ethical and thoughtful and have empathy.
I wouldn't want to ruin the business. I would like want to inform them. But if they know about that, that's a problem.
It does matter what we did today. People have the right to know what they're actually eating.
I think that is pretty interesting that kids in a classroom are able to find out such great information. Like, we could do something that could change how restaurants produce their food, where they get their food from, and label everything.
You can design different primers and investigate beef patties or identify genetically modified organisms. the whole idea about citizen science, that you can actually do your own investigations. They understand the value of what we're doing, that it's not just in the classroom. It applies beyond the classroom.
Great. Yes, that looks excellent.